In an arson attack, a Manchester mosque was set ablaze on July 16, 2017. Footage shows flames and smoke engulfing the Manchester Nafsat Islamic Center in Newton Heath, which was left gutted by the blaze after it took hold on Sunday's night. The damage has left its 350 members devastated, particularly as they had just spent thousands of pounds on building's renovation. The mosque worship area, three classrooms, and the kitchen had been damaged. The people on the occasion said that we have tried so hard to integrate with the community. We have regular meetings with non-Muslims to demonstrate that we are peace-loving people. Greater Manchester Police said that the offender approached the premises and forced open a window before placing an unknown accelerant inside. Images taken by witnesses show flames coming out from roof of the building, lighting up the sky and surrounding houses. Chief Inspector Greater Manchester Police Paul Walker said, "People are understandably shocked that someone has attacked a place of worship. We are investigating this as a hate crime which has damaged a place of worship used by the members of the Nigerian community." Hate crime is often underreported for a number of reasons, but people should have the confidence in coming forward, as no one should be the subject of hate and intolerance. We are grateful to have very strong relationships and cooperation with different groups in Greater Manchester, and are working with the partner agencies to support the community which has been affected. He further said, "I'm urging anyone who may have been in the area at the time or saw anything suspicious to please get in touch with police, as you could hold vital information." Local Labour councillor John Flangan said, "This has been a dreadful attack on a place of faith. This is not just an attack on the Muslims' faith, but on all of us."
My name's councillor John Flangan. This morning I was called out to the fire at the Nafsat Centre. This, I'm told, is an arson attack. I feel this is a hate crime against a place of worship.
The spokesman of mosque said, "We don't know why this happened. We try to be good neighbors and we try to be involved with our local community." This spokesman said that there had been two other arson attacks at the center in the past 3 years. Not only this, there had also been other incidents in the past, including pigs' heads being thrown into the building, people urinating outside, and verbal abuse. "We are not bad people. I do not know why these things keep happening." Manchester Islamic Center Secretary Mansurat Adebanjo condemned the attack in a video on social media, saying she was gutted because almost everything they had now gone. Half of the main mosque was destroyed in the fire, she said. The same facility was previously targeted in an Islamophobic attack when unidentified people threw two pigs' heads into it during prayer, and a minibus belonging to the center was destroyed in a 2014 arson attack. Anti-Muslim hate crime has risen significantly in 2017, especially after terror attacks in Manchester and London.
"We got a call in the early hours of today that the mosque has been set ablaze again. We've been trying to work with the community to make this thing work. We are part of the community, but the mosque was set ablaze today and almost everything that we have is gone. It was burned to ashes. All the classrooms we have for the children has been set ablaze."
The Muslim Association of Britain has also condemned the abhorrent Islamophobic attack on the Nafsat Islamic Center in Manchester. Muslim communities throughout the country over the course of the past months have borne the brunt of heightened Islamophobic attacks. The attack on the Nafsat Islamic Center is emblematic of growing Islamophobia that has been plaguing the country. Authorities concerned should take constructive and effective action to tackle the growing concern that the Muslims have been calling out for many years. Politicians should also condemn this act of terror for what it is. Failure to condemn xenophobic attacks and rhetoric would further legitimize Islamophobia. Islamophobic crimes and incidents in Greater Manchester increased by 500% after the Manchester bomb attack, according to the police figures. Hundreds of complaints about attacks, threats, vandalism, and other incidents directed against Muslim residents were received by Greater Manchester Police in the wake of Arena Concert attack on May 22, 2017. Muslim organizations as well as individuals and families now say they face daily harassment and abuse by those who wrongly blame them for the actions of terrorists with Muslim identity. Police in Greater Manchester have promised to take tough action but say they believe the spike of hate-fueled incident is only temporary. The new figures released just days after an attack on London's Finsbury Park Mosque show one man killed and 11 injured. According to police figures, there was a total of 224 reports of Islamophobic crimes in the 4 weeks following the Manchester bomb attack until June 19. Some of these complaints were later classed by police as hate incidents, meaning that while not categorized as criminal, the events were disturbing enough to be recorded. In the same period last year, there were only 37 hate crimes and hate incidents reported, equal to a 500% increase. According to a report, about half of all mosques and Muslim centers in Britain have been subjected to Islamophobic attacks since 9/11. The report said, "What is significant is the extent to which the far right is implicated in anti-Muslim hate crimes." Research by an independent newspaper also found almost a tenfold increase in attacks in the days after drummer Rigby's death, with mosques being set alight and Muslims targeted at home.